Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome to Success Coaching Live. And better yet, welcome to Fun Friend Friday. I am so excited for today's show. So take a moment, log in, say good morning. Good morning, Helen. How are you? So yes, I'm car doing it this morning, or studio in car kind of thing. As some of you know, I'm traveling a lot this week, and so I'm sort of like a man without a country, but I have a car. But it's kind of also the lesson of just do what you got to do where you're at and quit trying to set up the perfect environment. And so often we do that in our businesses, and we're like, well, I got to have this, and I got to have that, and I got to have the right notebook, and I got to have the right pen and the right chair, and I got to go do this and do that before we launch ourselves. And trust me, that's just fear talking. So, you're in Austin this week. Yeah, I bet it's a little warmer than the 10 degrees I'm sitting in today. I joked yesterday, or New Year's Day, it was 80 plus degrees, and today it's 8 degrees. So, it's a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call in the morning. I kind of like it when I go out, and now it's, I will say, you know, finding the positive and the negative. Good morning, Miss Becky. I will be joining us in just a minute. When you get up and you do your 5 a.m. morning and it's this cold, it's almost like an instant facelift because everything just like tightens up out of the cold and you get like maybe 20 or 30 minutes of looking younger. So I may just move to the Arctic and do my morning time. So yes, today is Fun Friend Friday. We have Miss Becky. She's going to be joining us here in just a minute. I want you guys to take a minute and share this out because one of the things that I love about Fun Friend Friday is it's so spontaneous. So last night, Becky was texting me, what should I prepare? Do you need, you know, what questions are you going to ask? And she, being the professional that she is, wanted to have all the resources she needed at hand. And I said, no, that's not how we do Fun Friend Friday. We just fall into it and we have fun with it and we relax and we see what comes naturally through us and to us and from us. And so we have had so many phenomenal wisdom drops during Fun Friend Friday because we allowed the moment to teach us. And in that, it was very spontaneous and it was very authentic and it was real. And so I have to tell you, I'm loving Fun Friend Friday. I may have to make it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, because I have learned so much from my peers, from my friends. We start a conversation and you guys get to eavesdrop. And in the middle of it, I'm learning. And I feel as if I'm learning, then you got to be learning because I'm the slowest learner in the group. So Becky is going to be joining us here in just a minute. So take a minute, share it out through your Facebook feed so that everybody gets to meet my friend Becky. And we're going to dive into Fun Friend Friday. So when you're doing this, just so everybody that's watching and learning, if you put your phone in landscape mode, so like this, and obviously the camera's going to be facing you, and then you have your group of friends that you can slide across the bottom and find. You find the person you want. See, Becky wants to be in the video. She actually sent me that I want to be in the video. So I'm going to say add her as a guest. She's going to take a minute for the technologies to like each other. And she's adding, and da-da!
Hey!
First time, Miss Becky, you are a pro.
Wow. You were a good teacher. You sent good instructions on how to get on.
I loved your nervousness last night. It was like, what should I prepare? What should I do? How should I get ready?
I want to serve you well. You're awesome. And your tribe is amazing. I love joining you just as a guest.
Now we're done. After that, I can just quit and go. But what I have always admired about you is that you're somebody that like gets down to the meat. Like you, like all of the fluff and the fancy of, you know, being a coach or being a speaker or being a trainer. You're like, I got to get numbers on paper. I got to get plans on paper. I'm sure if I asked you and I counted to three, you could reach over and find your business plan within a grasp because that's the way you operate.
One second. I actually have multiples. I've got several mind maps drawn out of what we're doing this year.
Lots Look at that. Ooh.
I got 3 pages so far, and I'm still working on it. I'm super excited.
So did you guys see this, that she had it at hand, she had it visual, and she had it where she can reference it throughout the day?
Yeah, and the cool thing, too, is because it's a living document, as opportunities arise, I ask myself, does this align with where I want to go this upcoming year? And I can add to it and sometimes even take away things. So sometimes that's more important for me than anything, is what to release.
So I get to interrupt because that's part of my job here. Catch this, guys, because it is a living document. She didn't say, well, because I wrote it, I have to stay committed to it. Or, well, I wrote it, and so I'm going to check back at the end of the year, the mid-quarter, the midpoint, and see how close it is. It is a living document. And so, like all living things, it needs to be nurtured and fed daily.
Absolutely.
And it needs to be managed. And so I love the idea that you see your business plan as something that you're nurturing continually.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. You know, I think it's important to realize that we all, we do this word of the year thing, right? Many of us learned this from John Maxwell. Some of us learned it from Jim Rohn way back in the day. But it was pick a word and, have that be your focus for the year. And this is the first year. I've had a couple of years where I've been given multiple words. But this is the first year when I got my word and I knew it was only for a period of time. I don't even think it's going to be the first full quarter. And then I know it's going to shift. So I'm really excited about this because I can just sense there's something very new happening. The number 8 stands for new beginnings. And so with it being 2018, I'm really excited because I kind of feel like we've got the extra punch of that 10 behind us too. But I know that this year it's going to change. And I bet I just kind of have that sensing in my spirit that it's going to be that I'm going to have 4 words, 1 per quarter. And this first is refinement. And so I'm already seeing as I go and I'm refining my business plan and refining what I really want to do and where's my sweet spot for this first quarter. I've got an annual intention, of course. But I also broke down, as you saw, my business plan into different mind maps. And I'm really, really refining what each one looks like because my focus is to be in that sweet spot and not leave it for the entire year. So as I'm in that refinement process, I know there's going to be some things that need to be taken away and some things that are going to be very strategically added. And the thing I love about this is then it gives me that freedom to execute creatively because I'm a creative person. I get bored really easy. And so this way here, as long as I've got that skeleton there, I always check it back to how is this aligning with my overarching goal for the year and then also for the purpose of my life. And then just be able to refine that. So I love that it doesn't have to be just one document, just one thing, and you have to get stuck there.
What I liked about what you just said was first I refine it. So I gain by subtracting.
Absolutely.
And then I find the center, and anything that comes back in before it crosses sort of over the line, I go back and check, wait a minute, is this within now? Mm-hmm. Whatever a now is to me, whether it's the day, the week, or the month. Mm-hmm. And so I love that one, I gain by subtracting, whereas most of us think, well, the more I add, the more I'll get, which really creates nothing because is he managing nothing, everything. And that
chaos.
You said,
that's chaos for me. And I've lived there.
you and me both. Trust me, I tend to go there quickly some days. And then the idea that if it's not in alignment with my overarching goal, it doesn't wait a minute, that seems really cool and really cool, great. But how does that align with where I started when I wasn't feeling shiny object?
Right. I can get distracted very easily and I can get caught up in doing a lot of really good things. And there's so many opportunities. I just feel like right now we live in the best time ever in history because we have the most opportunity in front of us. And we are in charge of creating our destiny. And so when we take charge of what these opportunities are, we have to have a litmus test, or like you said, we would be all over the place. So yeah, it just helps me stay a little more focused, gain a little more clarity, and never leave my life purpose, because I can get caught up many times in building many businesses. I own several right now, and I get really get lost because I love to build. I'm an empower and I'm a builder. And so I love to build. I love to help other people build. And I can get caught up in building a really good thing, but it has to also come back to, is this in alignment with the purpose why I'm on the planet? And that was something that took me a while to learn. And I think it might have come with age a little bit too, you know, as I went through, and because I've owned multiple businesses, we've lived all over, not in Uruguay, but it's been an interesting journey to see how does this really line up with why am I still on the planet? Because if I had fulfilled my purpose, I'd be gone, right? So that's, I think, the ultimate is, how does this align with my purpose? And you know, I'm a person of faith. And so I just take it back to, you know, is this in alignment with why God really has me here?
So what I loved about what you said is, I have an overarching business plan. And if I was to really look at it, you have your business plan, and then you have your purpose or your mm-hmm. life plan. Mm-hmm. And your business plan always has to sit. It's the guardrails. I guess I could see it as the guardrails of life, that one guardrail is your personal, your belief, your purpose, and the other is your business plan. And nothing, you don't go outside of those two guardrails, because you know danger exists. And right. as you build your life, you're always like, okay, is this check, check, good, I'm in the right space, check, check. I also love the fact that you said, we have so many great opportunities in front of us, mm-hmm. but what heard you say is, but not all of them belong to us.
Right. Absolutely.
How is somebody that works, because your sweet spot is people building businesses, multi-level mm-hmm. marketing, direct marketing, all of that. How do you tell somebody that's a really great opportunity, but it doesn't belong to you right now? How do you test that thinking for you?
You know, you gotta listen to your gut. I know that that's like a really silly thing, and some people think like, well, what exactly does that mean? If it aligns with who you are, you're gonna have this unexplainable peace inside. You might be a little nervous because it's something unknown, but you get this peace that goes beyond understanding, and a level of anticipation, and you just know that it's something for you. If you have unsettledness, if you are constantly questioning or it doesn't seem to fit quite right, you'll feel it in your gut. The other thing is asking some of those basic questions. You know, is that in alignment with my purpose? Is this the time for me right now? Or is this for me to pass along to someone else? Because, you know, once you start helping others build dreams and build businesses, regardless of what they are, build careers, build families. Once you start doing that, it's kind of addictive. And so you're also starting to attract that, because you know, you're putting it out there, you plant the seed, it's going to come back multiplied to you. So many times we are just the garnisher of that dream or that vision. And it's up to us to help find who does it fit, you know, whose garden does it belong into? Because many times it's not for us, but we, because we are visionary and we're leaders and we've been planting these seeds, this will come back to us. And that it's our responsibility, especially if we are people builders or business builders, we will then be able to see who will it belong to and how can we best empower them and support them.
So you guys, I'm going to tell you right now, share that part and then come back and listen to it, because that's, I should end now, because I'm going to be thinking on that for the rest. I don't know for how long, because it's going to stick up in here. Long, it was good that we, by empowering others, we plant the seed for somebody else to empower us. Mm-hmm. And because of our fears and our doubts and our insecurities, we often grab at little things because we think that's the only thing that's there for us. And if we believe in our abilities as leaders and creative beings and, you know, all of the things, we understand that when we let it go into somebody else's because it's their season, their time, their mission, that it opens the gate for somebody else to now be able to gift it to us when it's our time.
Absolutely.
And so I love that idea that the more opportunities that come to me, the more opportunities I have to give away and create legacies of other people's success.
Absolutely. And you know, I had a really cool opportunity, Eric, this last, I'm a part of the John Maxwell team. I don't know how much of your tribe is aware of that, but I've been on stage before and I've worked with Roddy and done a lot of different things there. And right before the IMC in August, God put in my heart that it's time to start sharing my son's story. He's an autism overcomer. And we've done a few speeches together. He's starting a nonprofit and we're starting to develop this, but I didn't ever speak on that as one of my topics. And it was just kind of dropped in my heart to do that. So I worked on the speech for a few weeks, put it through, and I ended up getting into the top, I don't know, it was 15 or something. And I was blown away because I wasn't doing it for that reason. I was doing it for my own personal accountability because I knew I needed to do it because if I didn't, I could potentially put that on the back burner. And so the night before I got, that I made it to stage time and I was like, oh my gosh, this is amazing, right? But then I had a check in my spirit and I felt as if God was telling me that I got this position to give it away. And I thought, oh my goodness, but what is that going to do to my reputation? How's Roddy going to think about me moving forward? All of these things. I thought, oh, I didn't want to let him down. And he's put this faith and he's worked with me and, all this stuff, that noise that goes on in our head. But I knew in my heart, I had to listen to that. And I also felt as if God told me that if I went onto that platform, I would lose the biggest platform and the ultimate platform that he had intended for me. Even though I knew Jordan's story is going to empower so many people. And I had, this is a huge honor to be able to even be put into that group. And so I went to Roddy, told him that morning, he's like, there's no way. But I saw a woman's face and I knew that it would be for a woman. And he's like, well, I can't do that. And I said, well, can we just look and see? He's like, well, we're starting in 7 minutes. There's no way we can even find this person because that convention center is humongous, right? I already know where she is. All of a sudden, I just knew, right? You intuitively just know things. So I said, I know she's in Paul's room. I said, I think I can run down there and get her. And I have problems with my feet and legs, so sometimes they don't work real good. So it takes me a little bit of time. But I knew I could make it. But I had to also go and tell Paul. I walk in the room. Paul's getting ready to start. And he says, congratulations, Becky Spieth. You've got stage time. And I was like, oh, no, but I'm coming to give it away. And so not only was it a humbling experience, but I had to go in front of my two of my most integrous mentors as far as my level of importance and wanting to make sure that I felt like they saw me in a good light. God changed my whole perspective in about 2 seconds. So then I went over to the person and I gifted this to them. And she knew she was going to be on the stage and knew that she was supposed to, didn't understand why this wasn't happening for her, but because I was obedient, I helped her be able to birth something so much bigger. And so we've been able to connect and to do some different things, but I helped her realize a dream by just being obedient, putting my story and doing the things that I saw coming before me, but intuitively listening to what was the most important. And so it's not always necessarily about you and getting onto that platform or you doing the what looks like glamorous, and that starstruck kind of positioning in order to get to the top. Many times the people that are at the top aren't ever really seen. And they're the ones that are the wind beneath other people's wings. And that's a hard lesson to learn. But I can tell you, as I did that, I've started seeing everything in my life and my business completely shift, preparing me for that much bigger platform. So I want to encourage you guys, if you have something before you that just kind of feels like, is this really for me? Trust what your steps are that you're hearing inside of your gut, because what happens is it's that positioning. And there's a Sunday school song I learned that was, trust and obey, because there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. But I just to be happy at all. you have to trust your gut. You have to obey what you're hearing and take the next, the next first step that's in front of you, or the best first step that's in front of you, because it may be that you're actually holding someone else's dream and you didn't even realize it.
Yeah, you guys, are you seeing why I was so excited? I was like, I woke up like extra early this morning just to make sure. You are wisdom beyond wisdom for me today.
So sweet.
Word this year that I tried to get a better one. Like I kept trying to turn it back in. Like, no, that's not right. Give me a better word. Give me a better word. And people that haven't found a word, you sort of sit and you ask what is one word that encapsulates my lesson for the next quarter, week, month, year. And if you start up here, you want empowered, you want, strength, you want all of these like labels that people would applaud at West Point.
Yeah.
And if you wait long enough and it comes down here, then you're like rejecting it because that's pulling from your real self. And so every time I got one of these words, I was like, no, throw that away. That's too personal. That's too real. So my word happened to turn out, and I'm finding it more and more, is just believe. And I love the way you just gave that back to me by like, this is that you got to just believe. And believe is, to me, believe is outside of faith.
Yes.
I mean, faith is different than believe, and one isn't stronger than the other, but believe is that taking faith into action.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I know I'm guarded and protected and that all things are for me, but the believing is where I say, okay, I hear you. And as much as I want to be on the stage and be recognized and have the handshakes and walk down the hall afterwards and people pat me on the back and do all of that self, I'm going to believe that this isn't mine and move into action accordingly. So I love that lesson of that you're holding somebody else's dream and you just have to believe by releasing it, yours will come bigger.
Yeah. And I think it's a timing issue too, Eric, because sometimes, because my opportunity to get on that stage isn't over. I just could pass it along to someone else this time. And, I'm applying again this time just because I know this is I'm just supposed to do it. And so I know Roddy won't want me giving all this.
Roddy will probably ask you like three times. Are you really sure?
Are you going to do it this time?
Duct tape you to the stage. Just like, and then he'll just wheel you out and like, so he has control of it. Cause Roddy does not like losing control of a situation like that. But I also like the question to ask ourselves. Okay. Yes, this is in alignment with me, but is it in alignment with my now timing?
Right.
Like just because it feels right for me, is it the right time for me?
Mm-hmm.
Because if it's not the right time, it will fruit in the season that it's supposed to. I mean, we don't get apple trees, but it's still an apple tree ready to bring fruit. We're just waiting for the season of production.
Yeah.
So, man, Andrea, I love that. So just believe, faith in action. So the fun thing of Fun Friend Friday, are you ready for this part?
I'm ready. Back and...
Okay. Yeah, this is the best part of Fun Friend Friday. And so let me tell you, you are the first person to have international Fun Friend Friday cards.
Woo!
You are, you traveled all the way across three continents? Yeah, five
Woo!
Times. Just, so no, I was thinking I should just make new ones, but no, these are now the internationally known Fun Friend Friday cards.
Yeah.
We're taking it to such a high level for you because that's what you're all about.
Oh,
so we inside each envelope, as the people might not know, there is words like legacy or persistence or influence or modeling or faith. Interesting. And so before I left, my son and his daily duties filled the envelopes. You get to pick one and we're going to talk 5 or 10 minutes about it as a lesson. So,
okay.
We have rainbow.
Mm-hmm.
The light's killing this. Pink heart.
Uh-huh.
Yellow moon, or orange star.
Uh-huh.
Yellow Moon. So here's a teaching tip for you guys all. I wrote the names of the envelopes on the back, so when I'm showing it, I can read it down here. So if you ever have to do this, blue diamond and red balloon.
Oh, this is so hard.
Everybody,
there's three.
Let's see, do we have any guesses?
Yes, because I have three that I'm like, oh, I just love them. What do you guys think?
The Lucky Charms cereal comes back to haunt you.
Yeah. Too funny. Oh, my goodness.
You know what I just realized? I lost your green clover.
Oh.
Everybody lost green clover, so that must be divine that it got lost in the luggage.
Yep, I don't think that one was for me. That wasn't one of my top three.
Maybe it wore itself out and just stayed home for a vacation.
Yeah? You know, I'm really like tossed between the rainbow because of new beginnings and promises. I love the star because I believe there's so much greatness inside of everybody that they haven't tapped into. And I love the balloon because it's just like a red, happy celebration. Oh, my goodness. I don't know.
You would be so fun on Price is Right.
I know. I actually had a friend that was on yesterday. You had
door number one.
On door the program.
Door number three.
Oh, I'm going to go with the star.
Now, like I always say, in the spirit of Steve Harvey, I keep it where everybody can see the word too. So if I screw it up, this is divine. It's timing.
Oh, my goodness. Your word. See? So we've been talking about timing, right? You know, I think timing is one of your greatest assets, or for me, it's also been a detriment. One of the things that I love about the John Maxwell team, what I love about you, Eric, is that we can just come as our authentic selves, right? Stop this pretend stuff that we see on Facebook. Like when I'm having a bad day, you're going to know that I'm having a bad day. I'm not going to be raunchy or rough, but I might say pray for me or whatever. But I'm just going to just be very authentic here and just say, you know, timing's been an issue for me. I'm naturally a very shy person. And I would shrink back from who I am and from the greatness that was inside of me. And others could see it in me and around me. And I was not bold enough to take that step forward. And I would see opportunity after opportunity just pass me by. And I would think, well, it was because they were so much greater or they were more prepared. And I was always looking outside of myself until I really could internalize this. And sometimes with timing, I've also run my mouth off at the wrong time. Like sometimes getting better at this is, but I engage the mouth before the brain and then it's like, oh, and I'm swallowing my both feet at the same time. So I think timing is very, very important. There was our very first time that we went back to the IMC. They had what we called Think Tank Day. And we thought we were going to come and we're going to help them brainstorm. Our little brains were just so magnificent. We were all going to come back and we were going to share with our faculty mentors. You know, they wanted our expertise. So we didn't really know what to expect. I went to Paul's session and it was amazing because he was talking about limiting beliefs. And I wanted to walk up to him and smack his face, to be honest with you, many times. I just thought, that's just so wrong. Why are you talking to me that way? It just stirred something in me that almost angered me. And you can tell when your audience is a little agitated or things like that. And he just was watching me and watching me. And at that time, Paul was, going back to my word of the year, was not as refined as he is now. And he was very direct. And he said, one of the things in his teaching lesson was, he said, I want you to think about what you made last year, but don't tell me. So I did. And I put it in my mind. And he says, now I want you to think about earning that in a month. And I thought, you are stone crazy. Like there is no way. I busted my hind end to make that amount. I hope I can even hit it again this year. And it was not a super large amount, but it was decent. And so then he says, now I want you to think about earning that in a day. And I just thought, you know what? You're just crazy. I just thought, I don't even know why I wasted my time in here. And he says, the only thing that's holding you back is you. And I, at that point, was just fuming. And that's not necessarily my natural personality. However, inside of me, he had touched a really raw nerve. And it was my value and how much I valued myself. And I was seeking so much to find my niche market and to enhance my speaking skills and all of the skill part of it. And talk about divine timing. He, as I was walking out the door, he kind of shouted out to me and he said, come here for a minute. He says, that really bothered you, didn't it? And I said, yeah. I said, it did. I said, because I thought, why are you teaching us this instead of really teaching us things that matter? Right? He said, there won't be a more significant moment in time than what we're having this conversation right now. This is the most important conversation you've had up until this moment, according to your purpose. And then I'm like, okay, now you're egotistical. Like, I'm just over you, Paul Martinelli. And
give me my money. I'm going home.
Right. I was just like, oh my gosh. But I knew that in the innermost part of my being that there was great truth there. And he said, well, he said, I want you to do that because you can actually do that in a day. And I just thought, Paul, there's no way I can even do it in a month. And, you know, as long as I held on to that belief, which was a couple of years, I didn't. I kept right out at that same earning potential. But every single day, multiple times a day, I remembered his conversation and it drove me crazy. But do you know that once I lifted that lid and I lived into the timing for me, I did it in a month. And do you know, I've actually done it in a weekend. I haven't quite done it in a day. I came about $20 short. So I'm still not counting and I'm still holding that.
I lost my wallet.
That far. But it's about the timing for you. I want to encourage you though, if you're listening to this or you're watching this and you're thinking like, is there something greater for me? And you know in your gut there is, and somebody's been saying something to you and it just rubbed you raw. I want you to think about that and I want you to live into it because this is the time for you. The only thing that's holding you back is your belief. So I believe that we have divine appointments all around us. And right now, you've got more in front of you and around you than you ever could have imagined. And whatever that is for you, whether it's, you know, increasing your income or it's developing your relationships, or maybe it's even launching something. If somebody's been talking to you, I want you to know that if it's rubbed you the wrong way, what it's saying to your spirit man is, hey, I'm trying to live into your DNA while you're on the planet, because I believe we're spirit beings living in a meat suit. It starts aligning, it starts resonating, and it starts driving you nuts until you start living into it. So if you're feeling that, know to step into it and take the next first step, like the best step you see right now.
So much meat on that, you guys. Like, if you're not downloading this and taking notes, you've just lost about $1,000 lesson. There are divine appointments all around you. You simply need to walk into them.
Yep. And it takes action.
And it takes action. But what I love, when we look at the overarching call, and so this is where I get to do the summary, and you tell me if I got... First, I have my purpose, my personal vision, mission, statement of defining what I want in my headstone, so to speak. I have my business plan, and then I refine my business plan down to what, by subtracting the things that might be really cool, but they're not my seeds, my season, and I give those away, and then I take a moment and I wait to see the divine opportunities, and then I step into those divine opportunities in full belief and faith that I know, because I've gone through this filter process, that only the divine opportunities that are for me will call me by my gut, will call me into my spirit. And when I resist it, it's almost, I think of that push me, pull you from Dr. Seuss, you know, the animal with two heads. That your divine self is saying, we got to go this way. Fear, ego, self-doubt is saying, go this way. And we spend, and if we can just turn and look together, those two objects saying, I'm perfect, I'm safe, I'm fine, I wouldn't be called into this moment if I wasn't ready, then all of the stage time in the world will open up for you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Great summary.
I see you guys now. Do you know why I just like get so jazzed for Fun Friend Friday? Now, as we close out, your niche is, and I always get the terms wrong. So direct marketing, multi-level marketing, what is the word that best describes the people that you really escalate sales for?
You know, Eric, it's funny that you say that because I came from the direct selling world. And so I built a multi-million-dollar organization just trying to find my call and my purpose in life is actually how it got started. And then my team name was Becky's Blessings, and we just wanted to bless other people. So all we focused on was blessing other people, and we went to the very top of the company. We broke all kinds of records. We had the highest retention of anybody in the company. But I knew even at that point, there was a much greater call and purpose. So I went on to work corporately and did some things there. So I do work a lot with direct sellers, but I also work a lot in the faith realm as far as doing a lot of healing retreats for women. I work a lot with like Fortune 50, Fortune 100 executives. Lots of them are women, not exclusively women. Just helping them to really step into their greatness. So my purpose is more about empowering leaders. You know, my company name is Leaders Empowered. And if you go to my website, it's under construction, so bear with me. that is for my corporate side of my business. I also have BeckySpieth.com, which is more of my direct selling side, my faith-based ministry side of what I do. And I host a television program and some things like that here in our market. But it's for me, it is more about the empowerment of the individual and helping them really step into to who they are. Because at that point, when we can get everything clicking in the right direction, whether it is sales, whether it's team development, personal leadership development, organizational development, any of those topics, they all come into alignment, right? I believe that we are a triune being. And when we can get that alignment going, which we're usually just a little bit off. You know, that's what I love about coaching is it helps us get into that alignment. Then, you know, the sky's the limit. We become the best version of ourselves so that we can then empower others to do the same.
See, now I said that the other day to my son, that my job is to become the best me so I can give that to you so you can become the best you. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what you're saying. If I can empower women or empower people, whether it's through establishing a business that they control or just identifying with their bigger purpose in a corporation or in their family, that you release an echo that crosses generations and families. And I love that idea of that legacy that you're saying, that if I touch one and walk away, it's not done because I'm touching everybody that they will touch. Mm-hmm. And so it's multi-level marketing or direct selling, you know, it's who you know that who you know that who you know you, but you're doing it on a spiritual level that if I can transform somebody and empower them, they're going to be able to create a downline of that same giftedness. I love that idea.
Well, that's what Jesus did, right? And I think, you know, he was like one of the best leaders because he took a ragamuffin group of 12. He had an inner circle of 3. And then he had an outer circle of 70. And I mean, we're still talking about him more than 2,000 years later, still building and growing and developing what was in his vision. And so I believe that it transcends to every area that we all do this because everything in life is about relationships. And so if we focus on that relationship, then everything else happens from there. And don't get me wrong, Eric, you know I'm a results kind of person. I get super jazzed doing like strategic plans.
Two people I'd be afraid to be coached by would be you and Dr. Holly Kelly, because she's an Marine and you're a numbers driven person. Like the first, so how many calls? How many people? What's your next step? I'm like, oh, slow down, Miss Becky.
You know
how
what?
Are you today?
That's on my form because that was what I wanted to have everybody tell me at the beginning. So I have my clients tell me that beforehand. On their client prep form before their coaching session. So then we don't have to necessarily go there and I'm satisfied as well.
Well, I love the C in you, that numbers driven, build a business, build a life with concrete paper, something that you can reference to. Now, one of the things that I love when I get to hang out with Fun Friend Fridays, see, I'm getting better at Fun Friend Fridays.
I know that's a hard one, right?
I know. I'm hoping we don't have Fun Friend Fridays with Fred Fried or something.
Oh, my goodness. Because
that'd be really fun. So Fun Friend Fridays is all of my friends in the coaching, they're all doing different things to teach or coach or empower. What is your next big project or thing that you're working on that is kind of your next thing?
You know what? It's funny that you would say that, because I know there's something huge on the horizon. And I have many offers that are right, like that I've got proposals out for and things like that. I've got some things with the government that are going to be way cool with our armed forces. I've got some really awesome and amazing things for those that are affected by autism. I've got some cool sales programs and visioning programs and all that stuff on the brink. But I leave on Monday to go spend a day in person with my business coach for a VIP day, because what we're doing is we're refining and finding a new signature message for me. And this is something I've wanted to do for a long time, but I didn't feel it was time to do it. But right now it's perfect timing, going back to our word, yay. And I will be able to give you an update on what that is, because what I've done is I've literally cleared a ton of space so that I can work on this next new project. I'm not exactly sure what it is, except I do know that it will be my signature message. And we're preparing other things.
But let me just do this real fast. I think my phone just started to slip, and I was like, any minute now, I'm going to crash the floor. So in the spirit of promotion, I bet if they went to your website and signed up for your email list, when you come back from that, and I know you are going to be like, I got to teach this. You're going to be doing a teaching on it. And they can stay connected.
Well, that is some of the things that I'm putting together. Yes, I'm putting together the how-tos. Because I have a lot of people ask, you know, how did you build multiple businesses? How did you get the success that you've had? Things like that. And I'm a very humble person. And so I don't really put out there all of the things that I'm doing or my contract amounts or anything like that. I don't do that. But I have been starting to formulate, because this is what Master Your Success Faster and Master Your Leadership Faster, is I took my systems and I put them together, all the tools and that kind of thing, and I put it together in a box on how you can replicate the success with the different personalities, because I know the different, you know, we need to have everyone in their sweet spot according to their behavior style. And also your drivers are in there, but that's a whole nother training. So I want to be able to do that for people that are coaches and trainers and things like that. I'm not sure if that'll be my next big project that'll be being released soon or not, but just know that I am working on that, and it does filter through, like, you know, every single day you're sharing a great tip on what you're learning, right? So I have taken inspiration from you, and that's one of the things I've committed. I'm going to be doing more regular Facebook lives, just sharing as I'm in the process of that project. But yeah,
all right, so that was your
empowered.com, sign up and I'll share.
You all better jump on and start following her, because if what you delivered unprepared today was this big of a nugget, if you with you getting prepared, it's going to be like car-sized nuggets of wisdom you're going to be dropping on them. So, you know, I'm starting to follow. Well, I already follow you. I got to tell you, thank you from the bottom of my heart for all of the wisdom that you dropped on us. Now, if what I do afterwards is I go back and I like block my face and I listen to you and I take notes, I know that there is like going to be a whole lot of teaching I'm going to be coming out of. So I just humbly thank you for just falling into this moment and just letting it unfold the way it did. There's so many personal lessons I'm going to be driving in circles for an hour just so I can hear it in my head.
I appreciate you having me, Eric. I know that this is such an honor to be able to be with those that you care about most and that are relying on you and your wisdom, which is awesome. I love putting you on, like when I'm getting ready in the, you know, the morning and just listening, and I'll tune in throughout the day many times if I missed it in the morning, because we all learn from each other. And that's one of the things I'm excited about. If we're not friends already, or we aren't in connection already, let's connect, because I'm sure that there's things that I'm going to learn from you. And I need you guys to be a part of my journey, just like I needed Eric to be a part of my journey. And it's been an honor to be here. So thank you. I don't take this honor lightly. This has been just a blast.
We could do that. No, it's my gratitude. Back and forth all night. We could bow until our backs are sore for each other. But honestly, you've given me personally some lessons that I get to now unpack for the rest of the day or for however long. And I'm holding that. I love that idea that there's divine moments waiting for me today to step in, and there are divine mm-hmm. gifts for me to give, that I yes. don't have to own it all to be successful, that I now have this idea of like, this isn't for me. And that's where, when we talked last night, I said, through me, to me, or for me is how I like to approach these calls. And I can see a lot of through me's, but a lot more to me's right now. So thank you for all of that to me. And to everybody that joined in, do me a favor, share this out, then run over and join up on Becky's Facebook page, and then go check out her website, and you'll drop the link down there.
Yes.
So that they can follow along. Because I know you're unpacking big stuff in 2018. And y'all be fools if you weren't sitting there waiting to see what came out of the box.
I would say this will be my biggest year yet. I just know that God's been preparing me for about 3 years. And I know now's the time to step into doing a lot of the work that I've wanted to do. And I'm really, really excited. It will be a very big year, lots of impactful things. And I'm excited to take the journey with all of you. And yeah, thank you so much for joining me, guys, and joining Eric. This has been fun. I've been watching your comments. And thank you so much for the kind things that you've been saying. It's been a blast to be here.
Aren't they a great bunch of people?
Yes. Oh my goodness. Of course. And some of them I know
it's really
like,
hard.
I love that.
I'm like, I try and move into student mode when you're speaking, but then I'm also like, oh, I got to be the host and say thank you to all the people. Let's just see if I can swipe them. And so Lisa and Melanie and Deborah and Tammy and Todd and I can't see them all the way the sun is hitting the phone. But thank you guys for joining us this morning. It has been another edition of Fun Friend Friday. And this is like, truly, I am loving the people that are asking or talking about it. And we've got a couple weeks already planned out for more Fun Friend Friday, folks. Ooh, now we just added another F to it. So thank you for being one of our Fun Friend Fridays. I think I need to like get a badge that you can say I was a Fun Friend Friday.
Yeah, I agree. That would be so fun.
We'll get Melanie to
make one more little invitation? I do a free Bible study every Monday morning at 8:30 Central, so it won't conflict with this. So it's 8:30 Central, and I just want to invite you guys to join me. You can check out, just go to my timeline or go to BeckySpieth.com. The information's there. But if you just want to start the week off and feel like, you know what, I just need some empowerment and encouragement, it's very uplifting. I just want to invite you guys to join me. I don't normally make that invitation, but I just kind of feel impressed to do that. So I'd love to have you join me 8:30 a.m.
That's on Mondays. I take morning.
Prayer request at 8:25, and it's awesome. So I'd love to have you join us.
That, yeah, y'all should. Lord, that's an invitation that if you turn down, you're just foolish. Well, thank you guys so much. Go off and make today a great success. Think of those divine moments that are around you that you've been fearful of stepping into, and just take action one step towards it. And if you receive a gift, but you know that it's not in alignment with where you should be today, don't be afraid to let it go. Pass it on. Talk about it, and the person that's supposed to receive it will show up.
Yes.
Great lessons. Thank you so much. I'm just so excited. Thank you for giving me this gift today.
Thank you guys.
Bye-bye, everybody.